Richmond, there wasn't like a club scene. I mean, the only places you could play were like Holiday Inns and things like that. And it was just, it was incredible. You'd be sitting there and you'd be singing songs, and then you'd have to announce that, you know, drinks would be half price in the next half hour, and you know, that kind of thing. And so I would get the newspaper and I would read about this place called Catch a Rising Star. And Chevy Chase was there, Robin Williams, all these people were, this is the place you could go, and they didn't pay you any money, but anyone could go off the street and work out, do you know what I mean, and try stuff, and people would see you, and you know, agents, I was like, oh, this is for me, you know, that kind of thing. And I would bring them the newspapers on Sunday and go, look at this, this is the real world, this is Richmond, this is the real world, I have to leave. Standing so close to me, the did you get a chance to talk to Bud about me doing my song with the band?
I think I'm not ashamed.
You know, you never want to talk about my career, Artie.
What career, Ben?
When I first went to New York, I still did cabaret music, and in the meantime, I was trying to find my own voice, because when you're doing cover songs, you take little snippets from everyone's voice, you know, little Barbara in here, little Judy Garland in here, you know, whatever you're choosing, and your voice gets masked. So once I started singing originals, there was no one to emulate, so it just evolved like so. My voice was very different then, because it was still very trained, and I didn't have an affinity to sing this. I loved it, and I was always trying to sing it with the radio and sing it with records, me and Mick Jagger, please. I was going crazy, you know, and half the thing of rock and roll is attitude. When I first started, the most difficult thing was getting anybody to pay attention, to take you seriously. I had these executives, they would just look at you like you're a piece of meat, and how cute, nice little, cute little, tiny little girl, and isn't this fun, and we'll placate her, and well, sure, you can have a demo session, and you know, and then let's go out, you know, that kind of thing. So, I mean, it was the most ridiculous situation. And then they would desperately try to talk you out of singing rock and roll. They would say comments to me like, haven't you women learned? I mean, you know, look what happened to Janis Joplin. It doesn't work. It's too difficult. You can't make it. Or why don't you be like Olivia Newton-John and sing, you know, pop music or country western music, and because that suits women better. I mean, it was just so incredibly, you know, insulting and ridiculous.
Yeah.
So it was difficult in the beginning, but and then, like all things, the minute they saw that this would be a money-making proposition, then everyone said, "Oh, women rockers, yes! This is what we need for 1980, yes!" You know, so of course I went, then boom, the whole, you know. So, you know, money is always the reason that things happen.
Say I had a good time.
Live is still, to me, the most exciting moment, the absolute reason that you went into doing this. I mean, this studio is a very self-indulgent time for you to spend experimenting and, you know, trying things out and, you know, pleasing yourself. But when you get in front of the audience, it's the first time that you are literally getting the feedback of what you've written and what you've sung, and the word is going into someone's head and the reaction is coming out. And I don't know, to me, if you don't get to do that, I don't understand what the purpose is.
Well, we're just beginning this tour here, and we're having a good time. We came here to rock and roll. We're gonna do it till you fall on the ground. Go ahead.
Surrender all your dreams to me tonight. They'll come true. When you keep it all to yourself, I said you can't hide on the inside all the pain you've ever felt.
The moment for me is knowing that Lisa Marie Presley listens to my records, Elvis's child. That is it. That is, for me, that was it.
Lights out on a new frontier. Unleashed waves for the demons to rise. Time to show the changes. We're gonna run to now. We're gonna hide up on King's Road. Up on
did a short one.
Up on King.